Hello, welcome to phonics number 16, lesson 16. So, with this tricky words, what I'd like you to do is focus on, if your child is able to read the words, then just focus on the fact that they need to be able to write it as well so that it will help them with their sentences. So, the method which I feel has worked in the past, which is really good for your child if they're quite able, is to use the look, write, cover, check method. So it's when you get your child to look at a piece of word that they've been struggling to write. Look at it, you cover it for them, they have a go writing it, and then they check. Okay, so you look, you cover, and you write, and you check. Okay, so use that. You can all use it for any of your children. But it's also being able to read and write that helps with the tricky words. Okay, so again, focus on words which are tricky for your child to be able to read. Okay, if they're able to read the smaller ones, then, you know, just glance over it quite quickly. If they're having difficulty, then obviously revisit every day. I tend to repeat it in my classroom because you can't assume that the child has got it. And even if they are able to read it, there's the writing aspect as well. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Right, so again with the phase three sounds, go through all the ones that you feel that your child is unsure about. It doesn't hurt to go through some of them or all of them, because at the end of the day, every practice is quite helpful and useful. I'm sure you're familiar with the sounds at the bottom at the moment, so I'm going to point to the ones at the bottom and hopefully you can say it. Okay, here we go. Okay, so I'll randomly pick any of the other ones to see if you remember what they are. Fantastic. Don't forget this one. Ooh, or ooh. Okay, so the children tend to hold in their belly when they do the ooh sound, so ooh or ooh. And then you've got this one, a trigraph, three letters, one sound. Fantastic. Okay, so let's move on to the next slide. Again, with this one, it's all about how quickly your child is able to do it, and that shows also the fluency. So you don't have to go through each one of them, you can just point at different points, choose different ones each day, and encourage them to say it. It's nice for them to practice every day, so don't think, oh, I've done it yesterday, that should be enough. It's always good to carry on practicing, because then it keeps it refreshed in their mind. Right, so let's move on to the next slide. So here you've got reading. So technically we're into phase four, where they're expected to read four letter sounds, okay? So the text may seem quite simple, but for some they need to be able to read four letter words. Okay, so here you should help your child to use their sounds to say this four sounds, and then put it into words. So, help, and then tricky word, use their sounds, tricky word, and then. So focus on the four letter words in this, four letter words in the sentence. These are the ones, because they've got digraphs, it's not four, it will just be three. Okay? So focus where the digraphs are, focus more importantly on the four letter sound. If your child is quite fluent in reading this, talk to them about the exclamation mark, what its purposes are, get them to write the sentence again, like we've done in previous lessons. So again, if I model to give you an idea. So, choose a sentence, milk is good for teeth and gums. Okay, so, milk, milk. Okay, make sure they've got four fingers and each sound is represented. So, encourage them to keep the spreading fingers up and refer to it when they're using the spreading. So, milk is, and that's a tricky word, so they should know how to write is. If they don't, make sure that they've got the tricky word list in front of them. So milk is good. Good. Okay, so good. good. So good. Good. Look is good for. Okay. Here's your tricky word for a list for that. Milk is good for teeth. And then your sound. If it helps, you can encourage your child to underline the digraphs in the words so that it helps them to focus more on it and get to become familiar with it. So again, blow and go. Milk is good for teeth and, good word, gums. So focus on g, first. So g, and then finish it off with your g, Right, so then blow and go last time to make sure that your sentence makes sense. Milk is good for teeth and gums. And make sure to finish off the sentence with a full stop. Once you're happy with that, you might want to move on with other sentences. Make sure your child can't see the sentences, obviously. Dictate it the word at a time if he needs it. Maybe if your child is quite comfortable, they'll be able to hold the sentences in their head and be able to write it straight away. Okay? Thank you. That's the end of lesson 16.